Hi friends, welcome to the session. So in this session we are going to see about the usage of the text field and as well as checkbox, and thereafter we'll see the radio button example. Okay, so in the graphical user interface design of the Sphinx, the most commonly used controls we are talking, friends. Now in the earlier sessions we completed the discussion about the buttons and as well as the label with the usage of the icons and all. Now in this session we are going to see about the text field, how to use the text field, because that particular text field is used to enter some kind of the input data. And if you are referencing the checkbox, so checkbox and radio buttons, so which are used to identify selection of the elements. Suppose if I want to select multiple elements, I can go with the checkbox. And if you want to select only one option, then you can make use of the radio buttons. Let me describe those particular things. So after that, we'll try to implement those aspects. So if you are referencing the JText field, which is used for taking input of a single line of text, like roll number, name of the student likewise, and it is most widely used text components. Anyhow, three constructors we can make use. One is mentioning of the columns, and thereafter specification of the strings along with the columns, and most frequently we use the message oriented, the JText field, third category of the component. And if you are referencing the JCheckbox, the JCheckbox class is used to create the checkboxes in frame. Following is a constructor for checkbox with respect to the string notation. So the checkbox is a selection of the multiple items from the interface. You can go with the checkbox. Radio button is nothing but only one option can be selected by the user. Sometimes, which is you can create a group of radio buttons also, rather than creating the individual ones. And from that particular group of radio button, you have to choose only one option. So let me show you how to implement these particular aspects in the Sphinx based applications. Okay. So in case of the text field, so just I want to implement these particular I want to extend JFrame, which is a container, and within this just within the constructor we are setting the layout. Roll number I want to add, friends. So just I am taking the label. In the previous example we have taken the label, so label class, just label roll number, and we are creating the text for that particular label, roll number. And JText field, you can see here, JText field, so roll number. So just we are creating the text field with 15 entries. Okay, 15 characters we can enter up to that. And J label, label name, again I am taking the name. And thereafter one more text field here. So just I am, by default I am mentioning this particular name of that particular student here. Okay, name. And we are adding, as usual, after creation of all these particular components, we have to add these particular components to the container. We are adding that roll number, label, label name, and as well as the text name. In the main function, just we are instantiating, and just we are setting the title of that particular frame and bounds, exit on close. Okay, so this is a basic template, friends. Okay, just you can whatever the components you want to add, you can add in a simplest way. Okay, let us run this code. Okay, so just it is asking about the roll numbers, and I am giving roll number like this. And by default the data is there, and you can erase that, and you can make use of some other name. Okay, so likewise you can mention, so whatever the information you want here, I have not added any listener, friends, listener or action performed. So if you could add those particular things accordingly, you can submit the appropriate frame. Okay, so this is what how you can refer the text field. And I want to introduce this particular checkbox example also, which is very simple, friends, here. So just we are extending the JFrame as usual, and within the checkbox example, so for this particular class constructor, so we are taking the flow layout, and courses are there actually label wise. Just I am creating the courses, and the class for this is JCheckbox. Check some kind of the courses. So JCheckbox, initially I am putting this particular true, that is automatically it got selected. Okay, and second thing is JCheckbox course 2 MTech and course 3 which is the PhD. And we are adding all these things, whatever the labels I am having, we are adding all those things. And thereafter, within this main function, so just we are instantiating and J checkbox example boundaries and the default, set default after closing of this particular window, and resizable is false and set visible is true. So comparatively, just we have added few statements like with the help of the checkboxes. Okay, just I run this particular code. Now you can observe here, friends. Default, because I mentioned this particular course as true, so it automatically selected, and I can deselect that also, and I can make use of this particular thing. And you can choose some universities, they are allowing a combination integrated BTech and as well as MTech course, so you can select those particular thing. And some of the universities are opting MTech with PhD, so just you can select those particular things. Okay, so basically checkbox allows us to select the multiple options. Okay, and this is one thing. And next we are going to see about the radio button, friends. Okay, if you are referencing the radio button basically observes selection of only one entry. Now if you see, so just we are taking the radio button, and within this yes, no, maybe, okay, JD radio button class, for this we are creating some kind of the objects and we are adding the same. And by default, as mentioned in the checkbox, we are adding this particular S button as by default true. And we need to create a group. There is a differentiation, friends. If you are not creating the group, they are belongs to individual category. But I want to take the consent of these particular three in a single or a common group, so that I am creating the button group. And within this, you can add all these particular button, whatever the objects we have created, all those things. And vertical and as well as horizontal. And now I want to add these particular panel to the vertically in a panel. So just I am adding all these things as vertical. And these particular aspects, okay, so just to here radio panel dot set border, okay, so border factory, okay, just we are making use of create title, whatever the title you want to have, looking for PhD. Okay, so now content pane, okay, radio panel button panel, only one content I want to add one by one, and a layout window back. So now in the instantiation, after instantiation, just is an example of the radio button, and after closing all these things, these three statements remain same, friends. There is no change in that. And only the thing is, just if you observe the additional content in the radio button, we have to manage the group. Okay, so just by after creation of this particular group, and you can add the appropriate radio buttons one by one. Okay, so let me run this particular code so that you can have a look on this. Okay, so just we are looking for PhD. Because we are given, we have given yes as true, so just no or maybe. So, and you can observe here, friends, in case of the earlier example of the checkbox, we opted for multiple MTech PhD or else BTech MTech as a combinational courses. But here, as this particular radio button is taking the consent of the user, whether he is looking for PhD or not, he has to give only one answer, yes, no, or maybe kind of thing. Okay, so this is what how you can make use of the radio buttons, checkboxes, and as well as the first one what we have seen. Okay, so list. Okay, just with the list we did not see in text field actually. Okay, so with respect to the text field, just entry of the messages. So in the next coming videos and next coming sessions, we are going to see about the remaining aspects. Okay, combo boxes and all the other dialog boxes likewise. Okay, thank you.